all sorts of aromas is the most common. That's really what you want to use. Another thing you can do to prevent that liquid from leaching out of the tomatoes is to take the tomatoes and cut them in half or quarters and toss them with a bit of diced chili and some salt. Put them in a colander in the fridge overnight. And the next morning you'll have all this beautiful tomato juice in the bottom of your bowl. Yeah, put the colander in a bowl, otherwise the tomato juice will be in the bottom of your fridge. And it will drain the liquid out, because salt leaches the liquid out of things. All that liquid will come out of the tomatoes, the chili and the salt will flavor them, and then build your salsa. And save that tomato juice for making sauce or soup or even putting in a stock. Don't throw it out, that stuff's gold. There's fancy pan chefs all over the place that salt tomatoes and put them in pillowcases overnight and then use the water. I don't understand that concept, but to each their own. The other thing you can do that works really, really, really well is roasting the tomatoes. And this is another great way of preserving tomatoes. I just take these tomatoes and I cut them in half and I throw in whole cloves of garlic and whole leaves of basil and fennel seeds and chili flakes. You can use as much or as little chili flake as you want. And I put them in an oven. There's two ways to do it. You can roast them hot fast. So you can roast them at like 400 degrees for about 45 minutes and they'll get really nicely blackened and charred. And that's really lovely for a quick tomato sauce or a puttanesca or something like that. If you want to keep them for longer and really get all the liquid out of them, then what you do is you put them on trays and put them in the oven at about 250 overnight. So put them in before you go to bed I go to bed at about 8 o'clock these days, and take them out when you get up in the morning. And they'll dry really beautifully, and that's another way of, then you can just take them and throw them into Ziplocs and baggies in the freezer, or you can use them to make a salsa. And what I often do is I combine a little bit of each, which is what I'm going to do today. So, and salsa can have as many things as you want in it. I made one about a month ago that had zucchini and onions and peppers and tomatoes and all sorts of stuff. I always tend to sort of think of where I'm going to go with it in the end. Am I going to eat it with chips? Is it going to go on nachos? Is it going to be the base for tomato sauce? What's it going to be? And I sort of work the flavoring that way. But the base of any salsa is an onion. So, and I tend to like using red onions because I like the flavor more in a salsa. So you take a nice quality red onion. These are from here on the island. And I'm just going to mince that. And what I'm going to do, because the other thing you want to do when you're cooking, anytime you're cooking, is you want to have a balance of flavor. So you want to have a balance of sweet, sour, salty, and bitter. And the way to do that in this case is what we're going to do is I'm going to take these onions and I'm going to put them in a little white, in a little red wine vinegar and cane sugar. You can use other acids if you want, so not the recreational kind, but you can use like lemon juice, lime juice, red wine vinegar, balsamic vinegar. Again, it depends where you're going in the end. I figured since we were on Salt Spring today, I'd try to stick, with the exception of the sugar and the salt and pepper, mostly to stuff that comes from Salt Spring, so I'm omitting the citrus. But citrus is nice in there. The other thing I'm omitting from salsa, and you can put as much of it in as you want, is cilantro. I hate, hands up who hates cilantro?
Yeah,
there's like four of us. We're going to run off the island.
Yeah.
It's genetic, apparently. Among my other faults, this is at least one I can blame on my parents. It is apparently genetic. It tastes like soap to you, right? Those of you that said you don't like it? Yeah, apparently that's the deal. And it is genetic, so I have a legitimate. So if you, and I understand why cilantro goes so well in things like this, because it has that nice, bright, fresh, citrusy flavor. So bang in as much as you want. For me, what I end up doing is I usually substitute a combination of mint and basil. And I love that. For me personally, I like that more, but it's up to you. But the first thing I'm going to do is take the onion.